And now we start what's probably been done on a billion other hipster channels, a ukulele, intro! That's me! I'm very sorry, neighbors. By neighbors, I mean Beyonce and Jay-Z, obviously. Hey guys, what's up? It's Aaron, and this is my channel? Is this my channel? It's my channel! Yes, 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 yes! So guys, I'm a film student, which means I'm really into watching really old movies that no one's ever heard of. I'm one of those hipster film kids. And this week, I watched a fantastic movie called... High School. Look at that poster. That is literally the only reason I started watching. I'm like, this poster looks like something I would find on my Tumblr dashboard, so I'm gonna watch it. And I did, and it's nothing like you would see here. Here it kind of looks like a really cool artsy film that maybe had a really modern version graphic designer person. And it's just right now a whole bunch of butts. It's not about butts, although this one scene is.
The game is simple, Simon says, and I would like for you to play it too. Put your hands in the air.
Simple Simon says,
shake them.
That scene was butt-tastic. If you look at the poster, you're probably like, oh, that looks super cool. Is that something I found on my Tumblr? No, it's a movie from 1969, 67, let's look it up. This is the book that I find all my movies in. It's 1,000 movies you have to see before you die. You have to see them. Oh, dude, cool. And what is that? Is that another butt? But I'm in. Shot on 75mm, I think, black and white. Osti. Producer, Frederick Wiseman. Screenplay, Frederick Wiseman. Photography, Richard Lederman. That's not how you pronounce them, bear with me. This film basically is a documentary. It's a black and white documentary. This man, Frederick Wiseman, went into a high school back in 1968, and he filmed a whole bunch of stuff that went on. I don't know if it was realistic or if some of it was staged, because back then having a camera in a school would probably be a weird thing, I'm guessing. Why would these teachers be mean to students when there's like a camera guy who has this like massive camera that's going like shh as you film them? Why would they be like, I'm just gonna be myself? Let's get real. This movie touches on abuse of power. What a theme! Power. I have to write an essay next week about power, and you know what I just realized I can reference? A Space-Time Odyssey. Let's talk about this movie. Is this what I'm doing? Is this what I'm gonna do on a regular basis? Because I love movies, and I'd like to explain them and get to the bottom of them, you feel? High School is a movie that tackles abuse of power. It shows teachers being mean to students, teachers acting like they're better than students and that they know more than students, even when the reasons the students have are completely valid. But I guess that's what went on back in 1968. You were taught to respect your elders, respect your teachers, because they were teaching you nonetheless. It must be so hard to freaking be a high schooler back in 1968. This movie, you got like a kid who's like, oh, I have to go home. I have like a doctor's appointment or something. The teacher's like, you're lying. You have no proof. And he's like, well, I have a doctor's note. The teacher's like, that's fake. You're a scoundrel. Did they say scoundrel, or was that like 1930s slang? He probably said, you're a thug. YOLO. And they show like a teacher like just kind of making up crap to the students. And then she plays like a Simon and Garfunkel album, which I was very into because, I don't know if you know this, but I am very into Simon and Garfunkel. This is the Graduate soundtrack, this is Bookends. Let's get back to what I was talking about. It's like I just swerved off the road and went in the bushes. a bush of good folk music. But then I'm like, oh no, I need a tow truck to pull me out of here. Tow truck comes, pulls me back onto the road of high school. And abusive power is absolutely something that we're still affected by today. Vladimir Putin, for example. I did not say that, Russia, I'm very sorry. Patron Chevron! I think the one thing that kept me watching this movie for 2 hours was just the ability to be able to see what it was like for kids my age, 40 some years ago, living in high school, going to gym class, going to math class, sitting in class, just being treated like the relationship between adults and teenagers back then obviously was a little controversial, but it's interesting to be able to see how people lived and how it's changed from the way we are today. Out of 10 goldfish crackers, I give it 7 goldfish crackers. Thanks for watching, guys. I will see you next week. Stop and think it over. Stop and think it over. Stop and think it over.